Hello everyone, myself Prajakta Deshmukh from Jnanasri Institute of Engineering and Technology, Satara, working as an assistant professor in Civil Engineering Department. My topic of presentation is carbon footprint and plastic waste. This presentation is a part of International FDP on Environment and Sustainability conducted by D.V.I. Patil College of Engineering, Akurdi, Pune. These are the week 1 and week 2 video details. I have provided YouTube link of both the videos. There are 42 likes and 178 views of week 1 video. Week 1 video contains information about plastic waste, usage of plastic, categories of plastics, effects of plastic on environment, plastic waste management, reduce, reuse and recycle process of plastic waste. Week 2 video details are: number of likes are 34, number of views are 68, and this video contains information about ISO standards related to plastic waste management. After learning this video, students will assess environment and sustainability standards related with plastic waste. Student will categorize plastic waste in view of environmental impact. Student will relate carbon footprint with action of individual, a family, an organization, or even an entire nation. These are the ISO standards related with the plastic waste management. First ISO standard is ISO 15270-2008. This ISO purposes for the reduction of plastic waste and in support of the objectives of sustainable development. Top priority should be given on a product life cycle basis to general reduction of material and energy resource use, as well as specific optimization of the use of plastics raw material. Second ISO standard is ISO 14001-2015. It is related with the environmental management system. Is a systematic framework to manage the immediate and long-term environmental impacts of an organization's products, services and processes. Third ISO 17422-2018. It provides a structure for inclusion of environmental aspects in standards for plastic products. It proposes an approach which is directed at minimizing any adverse environmental impact without detracting from the primary purpose of ensuring adequate fitness for the use of the products under consideration. Next ISO is ISO 18604-2013. It specifies the requirements for packaging to be classified as recoverable in the form of material recycling, while accommodating the continuing development of both packaging and recovery technologies, and sets out procedures for assessment of meeting its requirements. Now let us see what is carbon footprint. Carbon footprint is the concept and name of the carbon footprint derived from the ecological footprint concept, which was developed by Willem E. Rees and Matthijs Wackernagel in the 1990s. Total greenhouse gas emission caused by an individual event, organization or product expressed as a carbon dioxide equivalent. This figure shows what is carbon footprint. Now, what is this GHGs, that is greenhouse gases? These are the some greenhouse gases, that is carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, ozone, chlorofluorocarbon. Now, how to reduce carbon footprint? There are different ways to reduce your carbon footprint. This figure shows this different ways to reduce carbon footprint, that is plant more trees, recycle, reduce energy use, or change your transportation, that is use bicycle instead of car or vehicles, reuse or repair, and make every drop count. It will reduce carbon footprint. Now, carbon emission and footprint of plastic bottles. Firstly, raw material. When PET manufactured, raw material embodied energy is 84 mg per kg and its CO2 emission is 2.33 kg CO2 per kg. After PET processing energy is 9.83 mg per kg and CO2 emission is 0.79 kg CO2 per kg. I have considered Coca-Cola bottle for this example. The mass of an empty single 500 ml Coca-Cola bottle is 25 gram. Embodied energy in one bottle is 0.58 kWh. So processing adds will be 0.07 kWh. So giving a total energy input of 0.65 kWh per bottle, taking 400 gram of mixed packaging as a whole, the figure is estimated to be 4 kWh per person per day, that is 3% of the typical total. Now, energy and CO2 savings. PET bottle recycling energy is 35 mg per kg per 3.6, that is 9.7 kWh per kg. For a 25 gram bottle, the recycling energy is 0.24 kWh. So, the recycling one bottle saves 0.34 kWh energy. In terms of CO2 emission, it is 1.35 kg CO2 per kg. For a 25 gram bottle, recycling the bottle potentially saves emission of 0.034 kg CO2. This is only 0.11% of one person's daily carbon footprint, that is 30 kg CO2. So recycling 880 small bottles will make one person carbon neutral for a day. It is a simple first step towards a lower carbon footprint. Water sustainability and plastic waste. Production of plastic materials and their transport are the largest sources of environmental costs. Moving to a more circular economy can reduce the environmental cost of plastics. Capturing plastic waste before it reaches the ocean could cut ocean cost. Plastic can enable significant environmental benefits in the use phase. The environmental advantages of plastics are not equal across consumer product sectors. How to achieve sustainability in plastic waste, that is reduce, reuse, recycle, recovery and landfill. Lowering the amount of waste produced, that is reduce, using materials repeatedly, that is reuse, and using materials to make new products, that is recycle. Now recovering energy from the waste and safe disposal of waste is to landfill. Thank you.